We often want to use batch render to make our renders one after the other, but the presence of disturbing objects does not allow us to do this, and we have to hide them for each camera. But this problem also has its way. With the help of scene state, this problem can be easily solved. Hi, welcome to MIMViz. In the previous sessions, we talked about batch render and how to render multiple cameras and save them in a specific path with one click. The subject we promised to work on was the scene state issue. Scene state has many uses, and today, we are going to talk about one of its uses. Well, our scene includes four cameras. Now we want to check the cameras individually and see their problems. Camera number one is acceptable, and we want to render exactly this view. Let's go to camera number two. As you can see, this furniture set is disturbing in front of the main subject. What can we do to solve this problem? This set can be hidden and then rendered. If we hide this furniture set, our view will have problems in camera number one, because we need it in this view. So we need a different method. Another way to solve this problem is to use camera clipping. Clipping is a border that specifies the location of the image clipping based on the distance from the camera lens. How can we use it? Select the camera and activate camera clipping in the Environment and Clipping tab. By enabling Show in Viewport, we can see the cutting line in the viewport. We play with the number to make the necessary cut. As you can see, the image is being cropped. In this method, by cutting the furniture set, the floor is also cut and destroys the frame. So this method is not helpful for us either. Well, we return the settings to the first state. We select camera number 3 for review. This camera also has no problem with rendering. By choosing camera 4, we can see that it has the same problem as camera 2. Both methods are not applicable in View 4. So we have two cameras in our scene that can be rendered without problems. And we have two cameras that need to hide some objects. Here we need to use Scene State. What is Scene State? It saves us from different states in the scene. We can access it from Tools and select Manage Scene State. A very simple window will open for us. In the first part, we can save the scene state. In the next window, we can specify what items from the scene will be saved for us. For example, properties of lights, objects, cameras. We want to hide the objects here, so we must select the object properties. we define a name for it. Save. With the help of Restore, we can return the selected state to the viewport. You can also delete or rename the states. Now let's create the states we need. We need all the objects in cameras 1 and 3, and don't want to hide anything. Therefore, we save the state in the viewport and specify a name for it. In camera number 2, we needed to hide this set of furniture. We hide it, save it in the scene state menu, and specify its name. By choosing the exact name, we can access it more quickly. Now, to ensure that the states are saved, we move between them with the help of Restore. We see that the states are saved correctly. In camera 4, we hide the annoying set and then save it. Let's remember to choose a specific name for it. We have now saved 3 modes. We can go back to any of them with the help of Restore. If we want to change something in the scene, we can select the desired state after the changes and click Save. Now let's see how to use scene state. Return to the Batch Render menu. You can see and use the full tutorial on Batch Render from the link I placed in the corner of the window. I have already added 4 views, cameras, and a specified path. At the bottom, we see a section called Scene State. By selecting each view, we can specify which state to use. Camera number 1, all state. Camera 2, for camera 2. I wrote the name of this state wrong. Well, let's fix it. We return to the scene state window and modify the name. We select view 2 again and activate the scene state for this view. In the same way, we specify the rest of the views. Everything is done, and we can start rendering. Well, the renders are ready. Let's see the result together. None of the sets were hidden in the first view, as we wanted. In the second view, the furniture set on the way is hidden. And so on for the rest of the views. You can easily take your renderings with scene state and hide the objects on the way. Thank you very much for joining us in this tutorial. God bless you until the next training.